Well, hi everybody, welcome back. So in our previous video, we saw how you can use Azure ID Connect Health to discover and classify your apps. In this video, we're going to show you how we can get to the next phase, which is to migrate. We know that customers are not going to go and migrate all the apps in one shot. In this demo, Luis is going to show us how to migrate one app and all the steps that go with it.
Let's migrate our first application. Before that, I want to show you that right now, ServiceNow is connected to authenticate with ADFS. So we can see here, it's redirecting to ADFS for authentication. If I go to the Azure ID portal, here, ServiceNow doesn't exist just on Azure ID. So we have created a PowerShell script that creates the application in Azure AD based on the ADFS configuration for the relying party in trust. This script is based on the documentation for creating Azure AD gallery application using MS Graph APIs. So now we can run the script. So while it's running, we can see on Fiddler the APIs that we're calling. So here we're calling the application's template API to create the application. We're configuring the claims mapping policies, configuring the application itself based on the ADFS configuration. Now, if we go back to Azure AD, we can see that the application exists now. So we go inside the application. We go to single sign-on. We can see that the configuration is done here on Azure AD because we did it through the script. Now the next step, we can skip all the three first step, go to the fourth one, which is setting up ServiceNow. We can use the one-click SSO feature. The only thing we need to provide is the admin, the password, click configure. That's it. There are some tweaks that you have to do on the ServiceNow administrator to make Azure AD the default service provider. That is well documented on the Azure AD documentation. The next step is to test single sign-on with ServiceNow. So for that, we're going to use the test single sign-on experience on Azure AD. We're going to sign in with the current user. Select it. Now we can expect to be logged into ServiceNow using the Azure AD credentials. Yes, so Azure AD has emitted a token to ServiceNow. The cool thing about using the testing experience is that provides to some requests and some response in case we need to troubleshoot. You can see here the claims that were emitted to ServiceNow. If we go to ServiceNow, we can see that we're successfully logging with Azure AD. Successfully migrate our first application.
In the demo, we have migrated our first application. The first application is very important. Choosing the right application will help you to quickly show value and begin to experiment with Azure AD. We suggest that you select a SaaS application that supports multiple IDPs and you have a test instance, so you don't have to interrupt the current connection with ADFS. Also, configuring single sign-on for a SaaS app is generally well documented. It has simple claims rules coming from the attributes. It's also recommended that the first app includes access to only employees from your organization.
Luis, you nailed it. The first impression is super important in these kind of projects, and choosing the right app is going to set up the tone for the entire project, and it's going to set the team up for an early victory. In the next video, we're going to take you from there, setting the single sign-on, to all the other cool stuff that you can do with Azure Active Directory once the app is onboarded. So see you soon, and I hope that this has been helpful so far.